What's your favorite part?
Welcome to Michael!
God, it's unbelievable.
That was so cute.
That was great.
Welcome. Kirkle.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I'm from Huntington, New York. I came to see Michael today because Michael's the best in the world. And Michael, I hope you do go back to touring because we need to see you more often. I hope this is the beginning, and I'm happy that you picked New York City as the place for your first autograph signing. Thank you, Michael. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Next step is easy. How are you?
Good, thank you.
What's your name?
Valerie.
M. Make that an M. Just make it an M. See?
Thank you.
Do we have a friend yet? You first time. You had that 4,000 ago.
Thank you. What's your exact time? Is that Indiglo?
No, this is a glow in the dark.
Light?
Yeah.
It glows in the dark. Oh, but.
You get a little light before you go at nighttime.
I see.
Okay.
Cool. Thank you.
It's a nice jacket there. It's kind of hard.
Thank you.
Lauren. Hi. How does it fit? What's your favorite sport?
My favorite sport down has to be baseball.
Baseball. You play baseball?
Cool. I like football. Thanks, Mike.
Good to see you.
Yeah, we.
Yeah.
We.
Yeah. You got my Madison Square Garden thing on September 10th.
Oh, yeah?
She gave me the Beanie Baby.
September 10th. The last happy day in New York.
Hi, Michael. We met in your dressing room at the garden. How are you there? Thank you so much. Thank you, Michael.
Sure.
Hey everybody out there, this is Mark Haefeli in here, Virgin Megastore in Times Square, where the King of Pop, Michael Jackson, is doing his first in-store meet and greet of fans and signing autographs from his latest CD, Invincible, which by the way is number one on the charts. And here are two number one fans. What are your names?
Mallory.
Mallory.
And Esther.
Now tell me, how long have you been waiting here?
We've been here since 8 p.m. last night.
8 p.m. last night?
Yeah.
Yeah,
we brought blankets, but we didn't sleep much.
Now tell me, why would you come here at 8 p.m. to wait overnight just for an autograph?
Because we wanted to meet him. It's like a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. We love him so much.
What do you think of the new CD?
I think it's really mature. It's better than like a lot of them. I like all the new sounds.
And what do you think?
I think it's really good. You know, it has a lot of like slow songs, and it's like, you know, he shows like his true feelings on it and stuff.
Now you have to tell me your names, because I'm sure all the people who are at home watching this on this live webcast would be very interested in knowing who you are.
Esther Myers.
Myers and
Mallory Myers.
And where are you from?
We're from New Jersey.
Where?
Nutley,
New Jersey. All right, let's hear it for Nutley, New Jersey, with Michael Jackson fans. Yeah. Okay, we're going to come back a little bit later in an interview with Kevin Mazur, who has been photographing Michael for a number of years and is here tonight doing the same thing. We'll be back in a little bit.
You're talking to this girl. What's your name? What is it? This one makes me cry, this one.
It's an honor.
Giordano, and I'm from Long Island, Ronkonkoma, and I'm here to see Michael Jackson to tell him how much he inspired me and how much I love him and how much I want to, you know, just hug and kiss him and squeeze him and tell, you know, give him some loving. Yeah, I'm so excited.
Hey, welcome back. I'm Mark Haefeli downstairs in Virgin Records in the middle of Times Square with the King of Pop, who is signing autographs and meeting fans for the first time in his career. And if you can see right back there, there he is, Michael Jackson, the King of Pop, celebrating the release of his new epic CD, Invincible. And I have one guy with me right now who's a little invincible himself. His name is Kevin Mazur. Kevin has been the photographer for Michael Jackson for a number of years right now, amongst many other rock stars in the industry. Kevin, what's it like working with the King of Pop?
It's amazing. It's a photographer's dream. There's so much excitement around him. Even the fans, it's unbelievable.
Now they say celebrities are very, very particular and specific about how they want to be shot, how they want to look, how they want to be portrayed. Does Michael have any like parameters that you have to follow, or is he pretty open?
No, he's pretty open. You know, and it's great shooting. You know, photographing him, get amazing shots of him all the time.
Right now, I had the pleasure of working with you at the United We Stand concert down in Washington, D.C., where Michael performed live. That was quite an exciting time. Did you get good shots from that? What was that like?
Yeah, got amazing, you know, most incredible pictures of him. You can't take a bad picture of this guy. He's unbelievable.
Now, you have seen Michael Jackson like not too many people have, close up and through the eyes of a lens. Probably a million people out there today would love to have your job. What's it like being a photographer to the rock stars?
I got the best job in the world, man. There ain't a better job.
Well, aside from me, anyway. Well, thanks. Listen, we're still down. I just want to bring on a fan now. We're going to meet the next fan that is right now. It looks like it's a young man who is getting an autograph and meeting Michael for the first time. Oh, he looks like he had a pretty good time. Hey, come on over here, buddy. You okay? You all right? No, you're not. You did a good job up there. What was it like meeting Michael?
I can't even speak.
You're my love.
Do you have anything to say to you?
I couldn't speak.
Let's see what he did. He signed. Here, hold that up to the camera. Turn that around. Let's see what he signed for you. He signed a card. Looks like we got a card here that he signed, a Michael Jackson card. What a guy, huh? And you got the CD. Show the CD to the camera. There's millions of people out there watching this webcast that would love to see that. See that? Isn't that great? Tell me, what's your name?
Renold.
How do you spell it?
R-E-Y-N-O-L-D.
And what's your last name, Renold?
About B-E-L-L-E.
And how long have you been waiting online for this moment?
And I am since 9 o'clock.
Is this like a dream come true for you? What is it about Michael Jackson that gets you to the point where you are?
He's a humble man. He keeps himself. He does his own thing. He don't rely on nobody.
Great. Thank you so much. We appreciate it. Let's see if we could get one more fan. Okay, over here next. Thanks, Renaud. We'll be getting the next one. It's a young lady. It looks like she's had quite an experience here, too. Come here, ma'am. Can I just get a word with you for a minute? We're webcasting live here, and I want to know what it was like meeting Michael Jackson.
I am so shaken right now. Look at me. Oh, my God.
Did he have anything to say? Did you say anything to him?
No, I can't talk to him.
Well, there you go. That's another reaction. Maybe one more. Sir, can we talk to you for a minute?
Yeah, what's up?
What was it like meeting Michael Jackson?
Unbelievable. I never thought I'd ever be able to meet Michael. I'm happy. I'm real happy right now.
What is it about this new record that makes it invincible?
It's just Michael, so it is. It doesn't matter. Anything Michael makes is unbelievable. Anything. Anything.
Great. There you go. Thanks a lot, and we'll be back in a little while.
Concord is going to Europe.
Yeah, right.
You know, it's
operating. So, you got another
one? You are such an inspiration. Thank you for being here.
Thank you so much.
Hey, hold on.
One minute. Now, we're flying really hard.
Get up. Happy lady, buddy.
What's your name?
Raven.
Raven. Is it Raven?
Next, we have one.
Mediterranean.
Here we go. We're down here at Times Square and the Virgin Megastore with Michael Jackson and fans who have met Michael Jackson for the first time. Not too many people have done that. What was that experience like?
Just for my mother. I love. He's my idol. He will always be the king of pop. I don't have nothing else to say.
Great, thank you. Rendered speechless. Absolutely speechless. That is the general experience that most people are expressing after they have met the king of pop. It's quite amazing. We're going to see if we can speak to one more lady who is just right now meeting Michael Jackson. As you can see over my shoulder right there, there he is, the king of pop. Excuse me, ma'am. Can you talk to us for a second?
I sure can.
What was it like meeting the king of pop, the invincible one, Michael Jackson?
What was it like meeting Michael Jackson? It was incredible. He is a fabulous entertainer. I someday hope to be around as long as he's been around. I personally think that this is his most awesome album ever, and I would sleep outside again.
You slept outside?
Yes, I did.
In the cold?
In the cold. You see my hair?
Well, is it worth it?
It was absolutely worth it.
Terrific. Well,
thank
it
you.
Is quite... It's quite nice meeting you.
Nice.
We'll be back in a little bit with more. Oh, wait, let's go back. There's Michael. We've got some more fans. We'll actually get the next one. Michael Jackson, by the way, this is the first time in his illustrious career that he has actually come to a record store to meet his fans, to sign autographs. It seems to be another phase of Michael's career where he actually is becoming much more involved with his audience. And once again, demonstrating how much he does care as an artist. Number one all over the world, in every country where records are released, number one, Invincible, Michael Jackson.
Orange one is yours, right?
S-A-R-A-N. Great.
I'm fine, doing good.
You still sick?
I got the sinus infection. I heard it on your voice in the interview. Is that the famous Angel? Angel Frankie Blue.
I love you, Mike!
I love you.
Hi, Michael. This is a dream.
Hi.
I met you. I said hello to you.
Don't walk away.
Okay, my name is Rawson Crowe, and I'm from Dallas, Texas. And I'm here because I am obsessed with Michael Jackson. I love him so much. I've loved him ever since I was a little girl. And he's the greatest. He's the greatest entertainer of all times ever. There's just no one will compare to him. And rocking the Thriller jacket. And we're just out here having a good time.
Cool.
Yeah.
Oh, that's cool. I would say this one.
Really? You like to dance?
Yeah.
I bet you're a good dancer.
Thank you.
Oh my god!
This is Mark Haefeli again back in Times Square at Virgin Records with the King of Pop, Michael Jackson, right back there for the first time in his illustrious career, meeting and greeting fans and signing autographs, and here seems to be maybe the number one fan of all time. Is that right?
Yes.
Of all?
Not really, but my mother's the number one fan of all time.
So you're not supposed to say that. You're giving it away.
She's crazy about Michael Jackson.
Now, how about you?
Yeah, I like him.
Let me see what he signed for you. Wow, look at that. Show that to the camera. Michael Jackson, huh? What was it like meeting him?
It was very exciting, and it was my first time meeting him in person. So, I don't know. I just felt happy inside, and I felt surprised because I never met a fan really like that before, and it was really exciting.
Good for you. Congratulations. The first of many more to come, I'm sure. Be good. Here we have another lady right behind us. Again, Michael Jackson right behind us, as you can see, signing autographs, meeting fans for the first time. Excuse me, ma'am. Here's one that I'd like to maybe ask you a few questions to. Now, quite a contrast from the last little fan that we met who was about this big. You're about this big. But still, Michael Jackson, the King of Pop, tell me, what was it like meeting him?
Well, it was kind of really fast. It happened so fast, so I didn't even have a chance. But it's pretty amazing just to see him live in person and never see that before. So I've never met anyone in Wisconsin, so it's good.
Tell me about this record. Do you like it?
It sounds really good. I haven't listened to it yet. It's really bad asking me questions because I'm not probably the best.
Did he have anything to say to you when you were up?
No, because I didn't even get to even look at him.
Now, what brought you out here? You must have gotten online last
night. See that girl right there? She's from Nebraska, and she loves Michael Jackson, and she called me up yesterday and said, can you come down to the city? I said, when? She said, right now, and we wound up in the city at 7:30 last night till this morning.
That's what friends are for.
Exactly.
Great, thanks for talking to us. We have one more. We got some maybe writing down some phone numbers here. Do you think maybe Michael slipped her a phone? I doubt that. But here, we need to, did you get that autograph yet? Oh, wait a minute, here comes a real, here we go. How are you? What is your name?
My name is Connie Jones.
Connie Jones, great. And you just met Michael Jackson, Invincible, huh?
Yes, I did.
Tell me, what was that like?
I can't explain the feeling because I've been wanting to meet him all my life since I was a child, and I'm just overwhelmed and I'm thrilled to meet him, and I would like to become on his label because I am a musician, I sing, and I want to be down on his label. So I'm pleased and I'm honored to meet Michael, and I hope to meet him again in the future very soon, and I love him today.
Tell me, what is it about Michael Jackson that makes him so special that actually brings people like yourself out here and the hundreds of thousands of others who are filling up Times Square tonight?
Okay, it's because of his music. He's so original. His music touches everyone's heart. I mean, from a child all the way up to like a 90, 95-year-old person. And he's just a wonderful person. He has a very soft heart, kind heart. He's loving, he's dear, he's caring. And he's there for the people. He's truly a God's chosen.
Okay, now I'm going to ask you to do one thing. I'm going to ask you to turn around, take a look at Michael, okay? The camera will take a look at Michael, and I'm going to ask you to look into the camera and give Michael your personal message, okay? So turn around, take a look at Michael. It's a personal message, what you want to tell that man right there.
Looking at me.
Well, now you...
Okay, what I would like to tell Michael is that I love him, and I wish him, you know, plenty blessings and more success in life and good health. And I hope to meet him soon. Like I said, I left a letter for him, and I want to meet him.
Terrific, great. Thanks very much. And we can go to another fan if we want to. There's plenty of them here. There's thousands of them out in the streets in Times Square today waiting here to meet Michael Jackson for the first time in his illustrious career, signing autographs. You can see him right back there. Everybody, little kids, adults, young and old, from this big to bigger than me, all here to see the King of Pop, the Invincible One, Michael Jackson. We'll be back in a little bit.
Oh, really?
Yeah, he was telling me like how he's doing with today.
Yeah.
Yeah, he says hi, man.
love you, Michael.
I'm working down at the World Trade Center. Okay. Ground zero. It's still pretty bad. It's still got a lot more to do. Have you been down?
Not yet.
When you get a chance, we'll give you a tour down there. You're absolutely amazing. My son's going to be here. I can't even think of the word. Thank you.
Hey, it's Mark Haefeli back here again in the middle of Times Square at Virgin Records, where the King of Pop, Michael Jackson, is for the first time in his career signing autographs and meeting fans for the first time. And here's one, Jamil Prigeon. Jamil Prigeon. What was it like meeting the King of Pop? How did you feel up there?
Oh, it was great. The second time I met him about 13 years ago. Nice guy. He said he liked my haircut. He asked me how I cut. I told him I shaved it this morning myself, you know. And it was an honor meeting him. He's the King of Pop. He's the biggest star in the world. And I love the guy. His album is great. It's excellent. And it's probably going to sell 20 million copies in a week or something. I don't know, you know.
Now, you're not lost for words. Tell me, what is it do you think that makes an artist like Michael Jackson survive all these years? I mean, from the time he was like 4 years old to where he is today, an amazing career.
All the punishment, all the pain, all the pleasure that he goes through all day, his family, his mother, his father, the way he was guided through his life, he puts all that into his music and his dance. And when you put that into your music and your dance, you don't just write a song, you don't just dance a dance, you have to feel it. It has to come out of you, or it comes out of the sky, wherever it comes from. But that's how you create, and that's why he's such a great artist, because he creates his music differently than a lot of other people will create their songs.
Now, hold on 1 second. We have a real treat here, too, because Jamil not only is a fan, but he is a fan of his dance moves and has a couple of busting a move for you right now. So hold on. Go ahead and see a bust a move. Check Michael in the background. Get the camera up and show Michael in the background. Whoa, Jamil, the King of Pop is giving him an applause. His sign of approval, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah.
Look at that, sign of approval back there. I'm going to bring in one of New York's finest right here if you want to go over and get it. Thank you very much, Jamil. That was terrific. Really appreciate it. We're going to bring in one of New York's finest, who is actually online here. And actually, she's got to go to Ground Zero, is what she told me. And really, when you think about it, that's the place where she needs to be right now. So we want to thank her and all the people, the New York Police Department, the Fire Department, who have been doing a tremendous amount of work down there for all of us. Again, we're back to Michael Jackson, signing autographs, meeting fans in his illustrious career for 30 years for the first time ever. Michael Jackson, Invincible. Mark Haefeli here in Times Square at Virgin Records with the King of Pop, Michael Jackson, for the first time ever in his illustrious career, signing autographs and meeting fans. And there he is, right behind me. He's been here now for about a good hour and a half, much longer than a lot of other pop stars that I've had the pleasure of doing similar experiences with. We're with a guy right now. His name is Phil Heck, and he is responsible for putting on this extravaganza today. Tell me, Phil, what exactly goes into a project like this? I mean, the store was shut down, the cameras outside, cameras inside, it's huge.
Store was shut down,
since 1 o'clock yesterday morning. There's a crew of about 150 people that have been working for, now it's about 18 straight hours putting this together. There are satellite trucks outside. We're doing remote microwave cameras from across the street. There's tons of audio. There's hosts. We have Michael to thank for it. He's been a champ. He's been a real great guy to work with. He's fabulous. He's been a trooper. He's been out here meeting his fans. It's really an unusual treat for us to have Michael at Sony. It's just great. We love it.
You know, it's really it really boggles the imagination when you hear the numbers and the time involved with something like this, and you think there really is one boss here today, and that's him right back there, the guy in the blue shirt. He's sort of our boss. Me too.
He's driving the show, absolutely. Without Michael, none of us are here, and we're thrilled that he's here and he's come back with his record. We love it.
Now, it's a nice job. Somebody's got to do it, right? And it might as well be you. Are you a fan, too, Phil?
Absolutely, since I've been a little kid. I mean, I grew up listening to the Jackson 5. I've been a fan for 30 years. I'm about the same age as Michael. Yeah.
Is this the first time you've met Michael?
This is the first time I've met Michael, yeah. And it's been a great experience. You know, and it certainly beats chopping rocks for a living.
And he's easy to work with, too. I mean, he's not intimidating, as you would think someone like Michael might be, or with his stature. Seems to be a regular guy.
Absolutely. In the beginning, everybody was expecting a little hands-off, stay back, but he's actually been lovely to work with. He's been really accommodating to us. You know, working with 150 people at once is not that easy, and he's been a real champ about it.
Great. Thanks. We appreciate your time. Again, we're here in Times Square, the Virgin Records store, with the King of Pop right there. Ladies and gentlemen, children of all ages, Michael Jackson. Mr. Invincible himself, the King of Pop, signing autographs and meeting fans for the first time in his career. We'll be back in a little bit.
Can you see this, Jay? See this, Jay?
Yep.
Tell us about yourself. Tell me your name, where you're from.
Do you want me to look at the cam? Hi, my name is Shannon Stone. I'm from Worcester, Massachusetts originally, but now I go to New York University. I'm a sophomore in college, and I've been a Michael Jackson fan since as long as I can remember. I think even before maybe I could even understand it, I was like attracted to Michael. Like there's just something so charismatic about him, and I completely love him. And I'm so excited to be here today.
If you could say one thing to Michael Jackson, what would that be?
That he means more to me than any other man could ever possibly mean to me in my life. And I would just be so honored to be a bigger part in his life. And that's my greatest dream in the world.
We're coming toward the end.
The end is over?
No, I'm just kidding.
Hey, we're back here in Times Square. I'm Mark Haefeli, and we're live with Michael Jackson for the first time in his career, doing a record signing, meeting fans and signing autographs for the first time in his illustrious career, here to celebrate the release of his new CD, Invincible. We got David with us here from Epic. David, how well is the record doing? Is it exceeding expectations?
It's doing extremely well. I mean, this is one of the best albums he's ever made. It's chock full of hits. You know, You Rock My World is a great song. Butterflies is a great song that we're currently at radio with right now. And, you know, he worked really long and really hard on this record, and we're excited about it. It's going to do really well all over the world.
This may seem like a silly question, but is it easy or hard to get a record like Michael's out there and played on the radio?
It's easy, because he's Michael Jackson. He's Michael Jackson. It's easy. I mean, radio loves him. The fans love him. The consumers love him. So basically, they're just waiting on him to put a great record out, which he did, and the rest is pretty easy. He makes it easy for us.
Now, we've waited, what, 6 years for this CD to drop, and now it has. Was it worth the wait?
Absolutely. Absolutely. Like I said, he's the greatest artist in the world. He's the King of Pop. It's not a hard sell at all. People are waiting for a Michael Jackson album to come out, and everyone is going to be really pleased when they hear it because he made a great album and it was worth the wait.
Great. One last question. What we have here is rather extraordinary. I mean, this is not something that Michael certainly has to be doing, meeting fans and signing autographs. They probably sell just as many records without that. What is it that brings him out here today? Is it his way of saying thanks for all these years of support?
Yeah, I mean, I think Michael realizes, has always realized, that the fans are important to him, and they're important to what he does, and he wants to show his appreciation by coming out and, you know, doing a little face-to-face and a little one-on-one with some of his fans, and this is a great way of doing it. And, you know, this is something that he's been looking forward to doing for a long time. And he likes to get out and meet people and meet his fans and talk to people about the music and get the love, you know, feel the exchange of the love that his fans have for him and that he has for them. And that's what this is all about.
Great. Thanks, David. That was really informative. We really appreciate it. And again, it's Mark Haefeli. We're here in Times Square with Michael Jackson celebrating the release of his latest CD, Invincible. There he is right behind us, the King of Pop. You could see him right there in that blue shirt, meeting and greeting fans for the first time ever. We have another fan right here I'd like to bring on. And hi, how are you? I love the hat.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. I'm excellent. Michael Jackson. He just talked to me.
What did he say?
Well, he just kind of nodded at me. But I mean, hey, whatever. You know, no. I asked him to autograph this for my best friend for her birthday. And he did. So that's amazing for me. Yeah.
Now, what is it about Michael Jackson that brings you out here? Obviously, you've been waiting online for a long time for this moment.
Well, I think he's the best performer ever, and I learned so much from him, and he helped me so much just to, help me be myself and everything, and it's great to be able to see him.
Now, I want you to do one thing for me. I want you to take one last look at him over there. A good one, okay? And then I'm going to count to five and ask you to turn around, look right into the camera, and give him your secret wish, okay? So there he is. You're looking at the King of Pop right now for the first time ever, right? Real close. So turn around and look into that camera and give Michael your secret wish right there.
I wish that someday I can sing a duet with you because I'm a singer and you're the best, and I'd love to sing with you someday.
There you go, ladies and gentlemen. The secret wish, Michael Jackson, the King of Pop, right over there signing autographs for the first time in his illustrious career.
My name is Eric Rosenberg. I've lived in the city all my life, and the great city that it is, and we're so glad that Michael has come here. And I've been online for a day and a half now, and we got knocked out of line, so I don't have a pass to get in, and I've been trying everything to get in. So Michael, if you see this in time, help me out. This is just, I just want, I've been waiting on here. I'm the biggest fan. People have done stories about me in newspapers all around New York. You are the man. You've got to stay. You got to listen to her. She's, come on camera. All your fans are waiting at you here. And there are so many people that didn't get in. Please help us, Michael. We love you. The next generation.
Michael, you still sing like old school, Michael.
The next generation of fans is here waiting for you. Love you, Mike.
They're very big. Two big guys. Hey, it's Mark Haefeli again here in Times Square at the Virgin Megastore, where Michael Jackson, the King of Pop, is for the first time in his career meeting fans and signing autographs. And if you can't see Michael right now, there's a reason why. The size of these two guys, their job is to protect Michael from what? People like me?
Actually, Michael doesn't really need protection. Everybody loves him.
Very good answer, very good answer. But nonetheless, you always have to be ready for those who might have other things in mind than just a simple autograph. What does it take putting together a security force like this, and what is it you're looking for?
Well, we look for guys that can be proactive and help Michael get through these lines as quick as possible. But again, all the fans do love him, so it's making our job much easier today.
And when you have a crowd like this, it's not easy to control them. So it takes a lot of work in advance, I suppose.
There's a lot of planning that goes into this. You have very well-trained personnel, and it all comes together in the end. Everybody does their job. It works fine.
Now, I understand they actually shut the entire store down today for this event. That doesn't exactly happen when I walk in, that's for sure.
Yes, that happens on special events such as this. We have a large amount of people outside the store. We want to make sure everybody's contained and people are online, and they should be here given the passes out in the morning time. So it's a little bit out of the normal, but today's a special day for us.
How many guys do you actually bring on for a job like this?
Well, that's kind of confidential, but we're well protected, everybody's well covered, and everybody will get home safe.
Now, do you know like how Michael is going to arrive and how he's going to leave all those secret ins and outs?
We go over logistics before he arrives with the management and also his staff, so it goes very smoothly.
Now, what are your instructions if there was to be a skirmish or a fan were to get out of hand? How do you handle something like that?
Well, we're all professionals. We're trained to quell the situation very rapidly, and we remove the person from the scene so that everybody can go on about their business and keep this a nice occasion that it is.
So far, we haven't had to do that.
So far, yes.
Not it's been a great time. So
smooth sailing. Got to let you guys get back to work. Thanks a lot. Here we are. We're again with Michael Jackson, the Invincible One, here celebrating the release of his new CD in Times Square. Michael Jackson, for the first time in his career, meeting fans and signing autographs. There he is, the guy in the blue shirt, Michael Jackson.
Can I shake his hand, please?
Except for Mr. Jackson.
Michael, can I shake your hand?
That one's first. Just say hello and then say it's ready.
Hello.
Thank you.
Love you, Michael.
You're the job.
Sorry. Angels going.
Got an angel. Pull it away. Pull it away.
The white top. Oh yeah. It was worth getting. Oh, she was amazing.
Hi, Michael. I apologize. It's a real pleasure. Thank you so much. I just want to say, you know, we're so loved because you give love and it's reflected in you.
Is it a gift?
Bless you. I wrote a poem that I hope you'll read and I hope you'll know. It's an expression of my love.
It's up there. This is up there.
You know, it's something intimate for you. Thank you so much. You've given so much to me.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Happy birthday, can you run? Happy birthday. I know I'm breaking the rules, but can you please take a picture when you're holding it?
Sorry.
My knees, please.
Yeah.
Michael.
Yeah,
just say yes.
Quick.
Hurry up. Thank you so much. Michael. Nothing personal.
Did we get the booklet? Did we get this booklet?
Yeah, I hate that. We haven't. This is the concert you know as it is.
Yeah. Rose. Thank you.
Hey, it's Mark Kafley again here in Times Square at the Virgin Megastore with none other than the King of Pop, Michael Jackson, for the first time in his career. Many, many, many years meeting fans and signing records for the first time. And I'm here with three fabulous-looking fans who I guess have been waiting here for a long time. First of all, tell me what your names are.
Tamara Jovic.
Tamara Jovic.
Chelsea Pethick.
Chelsea Pethick.
Sarah Carmel.
Sarah Carmel. Sarah, tell me what it was like meeting the King of Pop.
It was great. He was nice. He talked. He said hi. He interacted. He was a really nice guy.
When was the first time you listened to Michael Jackson, and what was the first song that turned you on to his music? Do you remember?
I think it was 10, Billie Jean, because I'm a dancer, so I used to watch the music video, and I always wanted to dance like him.
And you?
Billie Jean also, and Man in the Mirror.
Now, have you heard a lot of this CD so far? What do you think of it?
I love it. I love his CD.
What are some of your favorite cuts?
I like Invincible. I like, shoot, I can't, so, oh my God.
Okay, you're done.
You Rock My World. Yeah.
Like, yeah. Rock My World. Dynamite cut.
You Rock My World. It was the best one on there.
How long were you here waiting today in order to get this?
You tell the story. Last night we came here. We left at 11. Came here at 11:30 last night.
My goodness, you were here all night long. Was it worth the wait?
Definitely, yeah. Definitely.
Yep. Why is that?
He's just amazing.
Michael Jackson.
Turn around and give him a big wave and yell, Michael, we love you. There he is, ladies and gentlemen, the King of Pop with three of his biggest fans, and Michael Jackson right back there signing autographs. Still going strong. Michael Jackson, Invincible, in Times Square. What was it like meeting the King of Pop, Billy?
Absolutely wonderful. 22 years in the making. Couldn't be happier.
Now, where'd you get the outfit from? Is this just for today that we wore this? You got the shoes? I don't know if you can get the shoes or not, but check those kicks out. They're awesome, man. Something that Michael, I think, would really dig. Influenced by him? Is the whole tribute or something?
Actually, I'm a clothing designer myself, so I make high-end costumes like this. For entertainers like Michael, that's what got me in what I do now.
This is something you could conceivably see the King of Pop wear.
Oh, absolutely. This is actually from my personal collection. I collect these kind of jackets, and I work for a company, and we make military regalia.
Are you going to walk home like this tonight?
On the bus tonight.
You think people like will be giving you tips and asking you to carry their bags or what?
Probably. I've been called everything from Michael the whole day until I got here.
Kidding aside, what is it about Michael that makes him the kind of guy that he is, success beyond words?
Michael has a special power and ability to touch people of all races, creeds, nations. As long as he's been alive, he's just an incredible performer. He's just a really good person.
Billy Pellegrini, thanks. Great costume. I love it.
Thank you.
I love it. Again, Mark Hafley here with Michael Jackson, the King of Pop, Times Square, Virgin Megastore. And there he is, ladies and gentlemen, for the first time in his career, actually meeting, greeting, and signing autographs for that fan base, which has been so loyal all these years, Michael Jackson. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Hey, it's Mark Haefeli here again, back and still in Times Square at the Virgin Megastore. With, for the first time in Michael Jackson's career, he is meeting and greeting fans, and boy, they're having a great time. We've met people and children and adults of all ages, tall, small, and everything in between. He really does have quite a fan base, that Michael Jackson. And he is here celebrating the release of his new CD, Invincible. It's Michael's first release in 6 years. And I'll tell you, the radio airwaves are playing it like there's no tomorrow. It is a welcome relief to Michael Jackson fans. We're here today to be able to see the great one, the invincible one, and we have one of those fans with us right now. What's your name?
My name is Cesar Carrasco.
And Cesar, what was it like meeting the invincible one, Michael Jackson?
It's pretty cool.
What did he have to say, anything?
No, he just said hello. He's tired. He's been signing all day. I think he's... pretty much ready to go, but I think he's going to see it through to the end. I think it's just great that he's here. Everyone's here having a good time together. I think he's kind of, his whole message is about like some kind of unity or whatever. I mean, the people are coming to see him. What's happening is you see a lot of people hanging out, having a good time, enjoying time together, especially with everything going on in the city. I think it's a good thing to bring everybody into Times Square, Virgin Megastore, and just kind of see a lot of people together and hanging out and no one arguing or fighting or anything.
Yeah, now how long have you been a Michael Jackson fan?
Well, all growing up, I've known Michael Jackson ever since I've, you know, growing up. I, you know, every time a new Michael Jackson song's out, you know, everyone's running to get it. I work in the music business, or I work here at the Virgin Megastore, and so it's just a lot of fun to come and check him out, especially since you see him all the time and all his videos and stuff, hear his music all the time.
Now, are there any special talents that you might want to share with us? Like, we've had a few people do some Michael Jackson dance moves. We had a few sing a song. We had a couple. We had one guy who actually was wearing, like, I think a Michael Jackson quasi costume from 1982. You got anything for us? Like, belt out a song lyric, like something from Thriller or Invincible you can think of? Now, I was putting pressure on you here, but are you up to it?
I got nothing.
You got like, how about like a moonwalk? Everybody can do a moonwalk. Come on, come on, come on. We got two cameras here. Let's give it a shot. Give it a shot. Come on, come on. Just to give it a shot. A moonwalk. Here, back up a little bit. We got to get this. Here you go. Just a moonwalk. Come on. Ready? One, two. Come on. Give it a shot. I'm ready. There you go. I got to tell you, you get A for effort there. A for effort. All right. Thanks very much. Again, it's Mark Haefeli in Times Square at the Virgin Megastore with Michael Jackson for the first time in his career, meeting and greeting fans and signing autographs for Invincible, celebrating the release of his new CD. Number one worldwide, Michael Jackson. We're back again, faster and quicker than I thought, and I'm still in Times Square, still at the Virgin Megastore, but this time I'm with...
Filestone. This is a real crazy name.
Where'd you get that name?
My father gave it to me.
Okay, I like it. What about Michael Jackson? What are you doing here? What's this all about?
Michael's the man. I mean, ever since I was little, you know, I was since Thriller, so I had to go buy his new album, and You Rock My World, the remix with Jay-Z, it like blew my mind, a rap, and Michael Jackson just blew my mind, so I'm just glad to be here. It's crazy.
Did you get to say anything to him, or did he say anything to you when you were up there? I mean, you know, this is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity, let's face it.
I told him to do a rap remix of Butterflies, which is a real beautiful song that I dedicated to my girl, and it's beautiful. It's a real nice song. I told him to do a rap remix. If it happens, at least I know I'll put my word in it.
Now, did you bring your girl with you here today?
Nah.
Is she going to believe you were here?
I hope she see me on TV.
So she knows where you really are. Where are you from?
I'm from the Bronx.
How long you been a Michael Jackson fan?
Since like forever. Since I was a baby.
You got any like song, specific song you could belt out, like give us a lyric or two? Can you do us a Michael Jackson imitation, maybe sing a song or a few words? Strike a pose. Oh, there you go. Wait, do it. I'm going to count you down. 1, 2, 3, and then give me the pose. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Hold it. Hold that pose. Jackson. It is not Michael Jackson. It's Filestone. Hey, thanks a lot. Glad you were here today. Again, it's Mark Haefeli. We're starting to have a lot of fun here now, a couple hours later. The Virgin Megastore in Times Square, New York City. New York City, where people have come together at a time when we need everyone to come together here in Times Square. All brought together by this man in the blue shirt, the invincible one, Michael Jackson. And his record, Invincible, CD number one worldwide.
We're almost done, yeah.
We wrote it down. The number.
When he's ready. We're ready. Okay.
Hi, I'm here. Are you doing Michael?
Please be careful.
Are those angels?
I love you. Bye-bye.
マイケルスさんがタワーに来ていただいて本当に光栄に思っています。マイケルのようなこんな本当に世界に一人しかいないマイケルスーパースター小さい頃からヒットが何曲も何曲も出して素晴らしいアーティストだと思います。25年間のキャリアのある方です。音楽の歴史の中でも一番レコードを売ってるアーティストではないでしょうか。
Tower has had the pleasure of meeting Michael in Korea, in Taiwan, in Thailand, during the course of his swing through Asia.
And
I'm very, very happy that Michael has chosen to kick off his tour of Japan here today. As the world knows, and I've had the pleasure of witnessing, Michael Jackson puts on a fantastic live performance. Many fans throughout the country are thrilled to have Michael back in Japan again. Our best wishes to you, Michael. Welcome to Japan.
タマレコード、東急代表取締役、キースタフーさんでした。もう一度、拍手をお願いします。それでは、ここで、マイケル・ジャクソンから、セイハローメッセージをいただきたいと思います。Hello,
えっと、非常に日本人のファンは僕にとっても、とっても大事な皆さんなので、日本にまた来れて僕もとっても嬉しく思っています。皆さん楽しんでいってください。マイケルの肉声がここで聞けるなんて本当に400万人ファンがいますけど、本当に選ばれて皆さんは本当にラッキーですよね。本当幸運です。今日はですね、実はタワーレコードの1階にマイケル・ジャクソンの手形を、後日ですね、飾られます。そのセレモニーを今こちらで、やります。マイケルの手形をここで、作ります。これはタワーレコード第1号アーティストということになりますんで、これからビッグアーティストが続々とこういうセレモニーをやるんですが、マイケル・ジャクソンが第1号ということで、
Just one picture, with your new friend. One, just one. Just one picture.
Oui, oui,
Yeah!
ça veut dire au revoir.
Michael Jackson brings another dimension of entertainment. He is traveling around the world all the time. He's listening to the heartbeats of his fans. They're sharing with him their feelings, their aspirations, and he's capturing them and trying to determine what's best for his fans. What's best, and how can one maintain the interest and bond? Michael Jackson, you will recall, about 1970, I think, had his first number one hit. In 1996, he still has the number one hit, You Are Not Alone. He is the legend of entertainment, the most accomplished musician, entertainer, performer in the world. Not only is he an entertainer, he is also a businessman. How else can you explain taking an asset of $47 million, the publishing ATV, including the Beatles songs, and piloting that asset and folding it into Sony Music to today, that same asset is worth $1 billion. That's Michael Jackson, the businessman. Michael Jackson, the humanitarian, as you can see outside of this building, as his fans say, Michael, we love you. The Prince, with his commitment to business, global entertainment, multinational organizations in the world, for young, for old, based on traditional family values. They would like to see the senior citizens who have been neglected talking again to their grandchildren and their children. They would like to build this bond, this bridge, through entertainment, through movies, video, computer interaction, educational, theme parks, theme restaurants. They would like to bring stage productions, concert tours, all under the banner of Kingdom Entertainment. That's the goal, that's the vision, that's the mission. The real question is, can these two men pilot an organization to carry it out? Well, I'm going to let you hear from them so that you can make up your own mind. We would like now to hear from our first speaker, Mr. Michael Jackson.
Thank you. I would like to first welcome
all the journalists and press who are covering this historic press conference. And for reasons I will soon share with you, Kingdom Entertainment represents a long-awaited dream come true. My earliest inspiration to be actively involved in all dimensions of the global multimedia explosion was derived from decades of concert tours throughout the world. During these travels, I heard the heartbeats of millions of fans who shared their hopes, their loves, and their fears, and most importantly, their desire for a better life. It was during this time that I began to appreciate that global family entertainment could bring peace, brotherhood, and love to the world. Until recently, my hectic schedule and outstanding professional commitments left me little time to develop a specific strategy for a fully integrated entertainment company. All that began to change about 18 months ago when I first met my friend and partner in the Kingdom Entertainment, HRH Prince Al-Waleed. In short order, it was clear we shared the same goals and values, traditional family values. Through Kingdom Entertainment, the Prince and myself will combine human and financial resources to be successful in all phases of the global entertainment revolution. As an example, we intend to be active in theme parks, hotels, animation, feature films, interactive educational entertainment, and of course, character licensing and merchandising. And we're really looking forward to this incredible venture. And now I'd like to let my partner, His Royal Highness Prince Al-Waleed, speak.
So we've asked our promoter to work out a new way of distributing tickets, a way that no longer require a money order. I've asked our promoter to end the mail order ticket system as soon as possible so that no one will pay money unless they get a ticket.
In addition, Michael Jackson told reporters his share of the proceeds would go to charity, a figure that could total millions, although no one is certain what the amount will be or which charity will receive the money.
Brandon wants to know, he says, I've been a longtime fan, and I just want to know how, after all the bad press, you can keep going and doing the best job that any rock star can do. Is it the fact that you have such a wonderful wife supporting you, or are there other reasons you stay so damn great? That little southern thing in there. Despite of what the press say about celebrities or myself in general, I move ahead. I don't pay attention to it because it's garbage, it's tabloid junk, and it's not important to me. I have my dreams, I'm a visionary, and I'm very resilient and nothing can hurt me. I feel as if I have a suit of armor on. I have rhinoceros skin, and I'm here to do what I'm supposed to do the best way I can. And thank you for asking the first question. That's Florida. Is that Florida? Oh, boy. If you could be any superhero, like Batman,
Superman, whom would you choose to be and why? Gee, I like Batman a lot. If I had to choose one to be, I like Morph from the X-Men. Because, M-O-R-P-H. Because he's constantly transforms himself. He could become anything. And when you're not expecting him, he's there. And he's very mysterious. And I think he can even teleport, which is exciting to me. And be in one place at one moment and another place at another moment. And he can be all things, become all things. That's exciting to me. So I think I like Morph. He's not as popular as the others, but that's why he's exciting.
Michael, Darkham would like to know, are you ever going to tour America?
Am I ever going to tour America? I'm not exactly sure. We don't really know where we're going to tour next in general. We kind of play it by ear. It's kind of spontaneous. It would be nice, but I'm not sure.
Bonjour, Black and White. It's great to be in Paris, and I love you all. Thank you so much for everything you've done. I love you. And I'll see you again, and hopefully soon. I love you very, very much. Thank you.
Are we blind to the fact that our children are raging against the indifference, crying out against the abandonment, of thundering against the neglect? Heal the Kids is about doing something, about making a difference, and trying to help adults and parents realize that it is our power to change the world that our children live in. With two children of my own, I know what it means to have to balance the demands of family and career. And let's not even talk about finding a date for myself, even though...
Don't worry about it, baby. Don't tell him, baby. Tell him, baby. Work him, baby. Work him.
No, this... Even though Rabbi Shmuley keeps telling me that he's going to find me the perfect woman.
Quit lying to me.
My response is, as long as it's not a journalist. In 3 weeks' time at Oxford University, I will be delivering an address with strong implications for healing the parent-child relationship, and it is an address that is certain to surprise you. Until then, I want to thank you all.
I'm not faking this. It's not for propaganda or anything. He really does care.
I just think, quite frankly, first of all, there was never any charges filed against Michael Jackson. That matter's been put to rest. He always has maintained his innocence throughout, and I think that's certainly the American way. But if you know Michael Jackson, you know that he loves children. If you've ever been to Neverland, you understand his life has been about loving children, caring for children, and if you see him interact with his own children, you really get a sense of that. So I think you can, once and for all, people should really put that behind them.
Good evening, children, and Merry Christmas. When I create music, I always hope that my music will give joy to many people. If that happens, I am very happy. Giving joy makes one happy. Unfortunately, there are many children that are not happy in Germany and in other countries. During Christmas, this is especially hard for those children because it is on Christmas when they see what they miss. For some, it may be just a small present. For some, it may be a warm meal. For some, it may be a family. For some, it may be just a little bit of love. That is why I need you. I need your help. Let us work together and help those children. Let us reach out to those who are alone. Let us all tell them, you are not alone. This year, it is I, only I, speaking to you, children in Germany, and sending you a few little gifts. If you help me, then next year, we will do the same, but in many more countries. We will speak together, maybe we will sing together, and we will give gifts together. Let us think big. Let us find many people to join our effort here and all over Europe, and then all over the world. We can do it. I know we can do it. To all the grown-ups, I like to say this. To us, so many things seem important. Sometimes we think we are important. We are not important. Nothing is more important than our children. They are the future. They can heal the world. It is our obligation to be there for them, to advise them, to motivate them, to help them, and to love them. Let us encourage them to go for their dreams. And let us, as parents, friends, and relatives, help them to have good dreams. I look forward to the new year, to working with you children, and to create an organization that will help other children. I promise you, if you come along, it will make you feel good, and it will be so much fun. Merry Christmas. I love you from the bottom of my heart. Thank you so much.
You may already know, after my tour ended, I remain out of the country undergoing treatment for a dependency on pain medication. This medication was initially prescribed to see the excruciating pain that I was suffering after recent reconstructive surgery on my scalp. There have been many disgusting statements made recently concerning allegations of improper conduct on my part. These statements about me are totally false. As I have maintained from the very beginning, I am hoping for a speedy end to this horrifying, horrifying experience to which I have been subjected. I shall not in this statement respond to all of the false allegations being made against me, since my lawyers have advised me that this is not the proper forum in which to do that. I will say that I am particularly upset by the handling of this mass matter by the incredible, terrible mass media. At every opportunity, the media has dissected and manipulated these allegations to reach their own conclusions. I ask all of you to wait and hear the truth before you label or condemn me. Don't treat me like a criminal, because I am innocent. I have been forced to submit to a dehumanizing and humiliating examination by the Santa Barbara County Sheriff Department and the Los Angeles Police Department earlier this week. They served a search warrant on me, which allowed them to view and photograph my body, including my penis, my buttocks, my lower torso, thighs, and any other area that they wanted. They were supposedly looking for any discoloration, spotting, blotches, or other evidence of a skin color disorder called vitiligo, which I have previously spoken about. The warrant also directed me to cooperate in any examination of my body by their physician to determine the condition of my skin, including whether I have vitiligo or any other skin disorder. The warrant further stated that I had no right to refuse the examination or photographs, and if I failed to cooperate with them, they would introduce that refusal at any trial as an indication of my guilt. It was the most humiliating ordeal of my life, one that no person should ever have to suffer. And even after experiencing the indignity of this search, the parties involved were still not satisfied and wanted to take even more pictures. It was a nightmare, a horrifying nightmare. But if this is what I have to endure to prove my innocence, my complete innocence, so be it. Throughout my life, I have only tried to help thousands upon thousands of children to live happy lives. It brings tears to my eyes when I see any child who suffers. I am not guilty of these allegations, but if I am guilty of anything, it is of giving all that I have, all that I have to give to help children all over the world. It is of loving children of all ages and races. It is of gaining sheer joy from seeing children with their innocent and smiling faces. It is of enjoying through them the childhood that I missed myself. If I am guilty of anything, it is of believing what God said about children. Suffer little children to come unto me, and forbid them not, for such is the kingdom of heaven. In no way do I think that I am God, but I do try to be God-like in my heart. I am totally innocent of any wrongdoing, and I know these terrible allegations will all be proven false. Again, to my friends and fans, thank you very much for all of your support. Together, we will see this through to the very end. I love you very much, and may God bless you all. I love you.